The Muslim media has organized the second annual 100 Most Influential Kenyan Muslims Awards in a bid to recognize and acknowledge Muslims who are making a positive impact to the society.
The event that was held at the Jamia Multipurpose Hall in Nairobi brought together Muslims with various achievements in different fields. The 100 Most Influential Kenyan Muslims Awards by the Muslim media aims at recognizing various Muslims in the country who had tremendous impact in the lives of other Muslims.
The reason why people are talking bad and negative things about Islam and about Muslims is because most of the media are portraying negative things about Muslims. So I usually have one thing that I usually tell people, and that this is, if you have time to complain about something, then it also means you have time to create a solution to that something that you don't have to be complaining about. So that is how we founded the Muslim media.
Speaking during the event, the Muslim media founder, Suleiman Doro, said such events will help promote the positive side of Islam to the community and act as a motivational factor to the Muslims.
Well, the purpose of this event, you know, most of the time we have people, we celebrate people when they are dead. We don't celebrate them when they are alive. Huh? So the purpose of this event was to celebrate Muslims, to reward them. And we founded the Muslim media to tell the world that there are Muslims who are doing great jobs in society, okay? And to show the world they are not just terrorists, drug peddlers and polygamists, but we are doing a lot of work that needs to be seen in the world.
The event, which was the second since its inception in 2019, saw influential Kenyan Muslims receive awards in various fields including leadership and governance, business and entrepreneurship, community service and philanthropy, dawah work, media and communications, personal development and academia, science, health and technology, food, fashion and lifestyle, as well as sports and entertainment.
For me, the importance of this award, number one, it's to appreciate those who are working towards making sure that this ummah goes forward. So I think it is very good because it is a motivation. It is not only a motivation to us, the people who have gotten these awards, but also to the future generation. Because the upcoming young Muslims, when they see people getting these kind of awards, they'll also put more efforts.
Such an event, a part and parcel of Jamia's mandate and an objective. As a center, we are more often than not, we find ourselves always in crisis mode, not just here in Jamia, but in many Muslim centers. But for today, I'm happy that we are not firefighting. We are celebrating. We are celebrating the achievements of people who have excelled in their different fields.
We should know that Islam is not only da'wah work or spiritual issues. It is spiritual issues plus other issues that affect the society. Things that will improve the condition of the society economically, socially, even politically. So this is also an opportunity to showcase what Islam can offer, not only in the field of what we can say strictly religious issues, but social issues, economic issues, political issues, and the rest.
Among Islamic institutions recognized were Horizon TV, the premier Islamic station, and the Friday Bulletin, which received excellence awards for being among media institutions that have impacted the Muslim community.
Naona kwamba sasa hivi tuna maendeleo makubwa ambayo wengi wenu mmeyazungumzia, na maendeleo haya kwanza tunazo shule zetu wenyewe, tuna vyuo vyetu, tuna mabanki yetu wenyewe, tuna biashara kubwa kubwa, tuna viongozi wa kisiasa na kadhalika. Lakini ninaposikia safari bado hatujafika, safari kamili ya kufika kilele ambacho pengine tunadhamiria sisi kama Waislamu.
2019 we celebrated 100 most influential Muslims, still in nine categories. But this time we decided today we are going to honor and celebrate organizations. And on 6th of November this year, we celebrated 30 inspirational African Muslim women. So we decided that those from Kenya, the Kenyan category, which are 10 of them, we are also going to celebrate them on this day. And also the 100 most influential Muslims, which are you are here today.
Jamia Mosque Nairobi's Deputy Imam Sheikh Jamaluddin Osman, Sheikh Juma Amir, the Director of Information Center, and Saeed Abdallah, the Executive Officer, received the awards for the role they play in serving the society.
Katika mambo ambayo yanamfurahisha mwanadamu ni watu kumtukuza na kumappreciate kazi alizozifanya na kwa recognize. Mwanzo naomba Mwenyezi Mungu Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, the way we've been recognized in this world, Allah atutunuku na tufaulu kesho siku ya kiyama inshallah.
So this idea is timely, it is brilliant, it is really refreshing, considering that we have come through a very difficult year, corona, the drought, and all the challenges that we've come through.
Litawapa watu wazima wetu moyo, sote tuko katika bidii ya kutokeza kwa tuwezalo kufanya. Likiwa la kheri, usilale tena. Ikiwa liko la kheri unaloweza kuwafanyia umma, yawe maneno maili, yawe 12, yawe 22, jitokeze, watu watafurahi na wewe siku moja, na Mwenyezi Mungu atawalipa wenye kufanya na wenye kufanyiwa furaha za kudumu inshallah.
Supreme Council of Kenya Muslims Chairman Hassan Ole Nado called on the Muslims to remain united in all areas as they are the ambassadors of Islam.
We have heard enough of negative stories. You will never see anything interesting about Islam and Muslims in any publication globally. Anything you see is always negative. Who will tell our story? When do we see the positive things that we do? When do we see the least of the people like the ones who are in this room today? Who will tell this story? I thank Allah because at least some people are coming up and thinking of what should be done, what should be said, and how it should be done.
Sidhani kama mwakani ukumbi huu utatutosha vile ninavyohisi. Lakini ya Mungu ni mengi. Kila tukizidi tuheshimika zaidi.
Speaking to Horizon TV, Jumia Yusuf, the co-founder of Fadl Karda Leukemia Foundation, said it is important for the community to appreciate the efforts people are making for the welfare of the Ummah.
You know, being awarded in such a, being part of the 100 influencers, it's not something you can just get it just like that. And I'm really, really excited about it because it will motivate me as a community to continue all the things I've been doing for the Muslims. In the past 10 years, especially, I never stopped supporting the community, helping the Muslims, especially and the women.
Full names are Jumia Abdul Yusuf, co-founder of Fadl Karda Leukemia Foundation, which is an NGO that supports children fighting childhood types of cancers and also create awareness in communities. We reach communities whereby information about cancer does not reach, or the kind of information that reaches is very minimal.
I have been advocating for economic empowerment of the Muslims. I've ensured that I've empowered over 1,500 entrepreneurs who are Muslims coming from simple backgrounds. So I was pushing for economic empowerment for the last 3 years, and it's such an honor to at least be recognized for the work that we're doing on the ground.
We should do whatever we are doing in whatever field that we are in, because Islam is a complete way of life. We should be guided by, number one, service to the Ummah for the sake of pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So ikhlas, ikhlas, ikhlas before anything else.
For Horizon TV, my name is Sumaya Hussein.